What's up guys, it's Kelly and today I've got another swatch review for you. So today we are going over the Zoya Summer 2019 Barefoot Collection. So we've got 12 new shades, mostly creams, a couple of shimmers, and then one glitter topper. So if you guys are interested in seeing the swatches, then just keep watching. Ooh, I just realized swatch and watch rhyme. Okay. Roll footage. So as usual, I am using base coat underneath all of my swatches to protect my natural nail from staining or anything like that. If you're interested, you can check all that info out in the description. So first up in this collection, we have Joey, which is a really soft, light baby pink cream, and it's super cute. It's kind of got a little bit of a warm tone to it, so it's almost like a peachy pink. I like the formula, although I have to say it is a little bit sheer for me. I thought it would be fully opaque in two coats. It ended up taking three, but that being said, it did self-level really nicely, and the color is really gorgeous. I feel like this is more of a transitional kind of springy color, but I do think it looks nice with the rest of the collection. I just don't know how unique slash original it is, but like I said, I think it's really cute, and the formula was easy to work with. Next up, we have Tessa, which is a light peachy beige color that has a little golden shimmer running throughout it, and oh man, this color is super beautiful. It's just a very light, soft, neutral color, and I love how that little shimmer kind of comes through and just sort of elevates the manicure from being like a basic nude polish into being something that's like, I don't know, a little bit summery and sun-kissed. Yeah, I ended up doing two coats for full coverage, and I really love the way this looks. It's definitely a little bit of a summer vibe, but it's also like work appropriate and like event appropriate, so just a really nice color all around to have. Next up we have Kira, which is described as a light taupe that has a light copper shimmer running throughout. So this one I was really excited when I saw it in the bottle, but on the nail it kind of fell flat for me. I felt like, I don't know, the way that the shimmer looked, it just gave the polish almost like a heathered look, which I would have liked, but I don't know, it just looked kind of dirty. Like I felt like it almost looked like the material of a couch. Like not a very comfortable couch, but it's just, I don't know. This one didn't really work for me. I wasn't a huge fan of it, but I did get full opacity in two coats. Next up we have Marcy, and oh man, is this the definition of a summer color. It is just this really hot, bright pink, red, orange kind of color that has a really intense pink shimmer running throughout, and this is like the definition of summer to me. The formula was really amazing, the color was really amazing, it was just so bright and fun and easy to apply, and I did get full coverage in two coats. This is a definite pedicure color for me, but I know that everyone's gonna be grabbing for this color. Next up we have Liza, and I kind of had a hard time capturing this one on camera. It's sort of like a reddish pinky color. On the camera, it looks a little bit more red than it is. I tried to compensate with some color correction, so this is as close as I could get it without making my skin look alienish, but just another really gorgeous, bright, summery color. Amazing cream formula that Zoya always has, and it was almost a one coater. I did end up throwing on a second coat for full coverage, and I was just really into this one. It's very gorgeous. Okay, next up we have Robbie, and this is by far my favorite in the entire collection. It is so absolutely stunning. It is described as a raspberry color, it's got a little bit of a shimmer in it, and it's got these gold flecks, which I am totally feeling this season. Oh my gosh, absolutely beautiful. It was pretty much a one coater, but with colors like this, you always want to throw on a second coat so you can just get more of that exciting shimmer and little gold fleck to it, add some depth to it. Oh my gosh, what a fun and bright color. I cannot wait to wear this one. It's just so beautiful and fun. Next up we have Daisy, I think that's how you pronounce it. In the bottle it kind of looked like a Pepto-Bismol color, but on the nail, I was super excited to see that this is just like a super bright, almost neon Barbie pink cream. So beautiful, definitely does not have the Pepto-Bismol vibes on the nail, and it was fully opaque in two coats, which is just super gorgeous. I'm excited to use this one for nail art because I do love having just a classic pink like this, but it also wears really nicely on its own. So another gorgeous color. Next up we have Rye. I think that's also how you pronounce this one. These are all names, so it's hard to look up how to pronounce them. But anyway, this is a beautiful, warm-toned, pinky, kind of almost magenta cream. And it's described on the website as being cool-toned, but it is absolutely not cool-toned. I don't know why they did that. But another super gorgeous color. It's always hard to make a dark color like this into a summery shade, but they've definitely managed to do it. It's almost like a bright, dark purple, if that makes sense. I got full coverage in two coats. Next up, we have the shade Walker, which is another
color that I was super excited about because I absolutely love wearing these like rich blues in the summer. This one is a little bit lighter than like a primary blue, and it is a cream, and I actually thought it was just really interesting just because it is a little bit lighter than most of these like kind of rich summery blues that you usually see. It almost has like a slight pastel hint to it, so I really love that. It was surprisingly a little bit sheer on the first coat, but I did end up getting full coverage on that second coat, and it was just a beautiful color. Next up we have Eleni. I don't know how to pronounce this one either. Oh my gosh, I'm butchering these names. I'm so sorry. Anyway, this is a super, super, super light minty blue color, and it's almost white, but it does have that nice little color to it. Again, a little bit sheer on the first coat. I did end up getting full coverage on the second coat, and I just think it's a really lovely, like, light, fun manicure. Like, I could see myself wearing this to the beach and it just being like a really fun, bright summer color. Next up, we have the color B, which is a really, really light, almost pastel yellow cream, and I was super excited about this one, and I was really impressed with the formula at first, but it was another three coater, which I wasn't totally thrilled about. It was nice because working with pastel colors tends to get a little bit chalky, and I was really impressed that this formula was super smooth and nice, but I did notice a little bit of patchiness on the second coat, so I did have to do a third coat to make it full coverage. I don't love wearing three coaters, but I think this color is so beautiful that it's definitely worth it, and I don't know, it's just like, even though it's a pastel shade, it definitely has a summery vibe to me because it's just so bright and fun. And last but not least, we have Dallas, which is a topper that features matte white hex glitters as well as little mini silver metallic glitters. And oh my gosh, I feel like this color would look good over any of the colors in this collection. I am totally obsessed with this topper. It's so fun. It's interesting. I do not have any colors like this, and I can't wait to try it over pretty much every single color.
Okay, so thoughts on this collection? 100% into it. So this might be my bias about summer collections in general, because I tend to think spring collections get a little bit boring. So whenever the summer polishes start coming out, I get super hyped up because I love seeing the bright, exciting colors that come with summer, as opposed to like the muted, soft shades that come with spring. So really excited about this. Like I said, might be a little bit of a bias, but I'm good with it. So there's like this nice split between the kind of conservative colors that a lot of people tend to go towards, like the reds and the pinks and the nudes. And then we've got the bright, fun, like different kinds of colors. So I like that they separated the collection into two sections like that. I like that they have something for everybody. And I really love that topper. I honestly think it would look good over any of the colors in the collection, but especially over those bright, funky colors, because it's just a really interesting glitter topper. And I feel like it's hard to do a glitter topper that hasn't been done before. So I'm really impressed with that. So these polishes retail for $10 USD on the Zoya website. You can also get them at a ton of retailers. And Zoya is one of those really great brands that is 10 free, meaning it's free of 10 of like the really harmful chemicals that are generally found in nail polish. They're cruelty free. I believe they're vegan. I will double check and write right here if that is a true statement. But yeah, it's just a really great brand. As far as I have been told, I don't wear nail polish for 10 days at a time, but I have been told that it can last up to 10 days on a lot of people. And my mom is one of those people who has endorsed it. So I believe her, do you? Anyway, that is it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know in the comments which color is your fave if you're gonna be picking any of them up. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy my swatch and reviews. And that's it. So I'll talk to you guys later. Bye. Okay, so fun fact, I feel like this hair color that I just recently got, I don't even remember when I did it, but it was recent, but I feel like this is the quickest a hair color has ever washed out on me. I know it still looks pretty bright, but I feel like it doesn't look as like almost neon as it did when I first did it. And I think a part of that is because I've been a little bit lazy with washing and I've been kind of using warm water. I always used to use cold water just because that would make it stay longer, but I don't know. Sometimes I just get cold in the shower and I gotta use warm water. So that's my fun fact for today, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.